we got some more coming in.
I think it's 41 once they get here. Get the Lord. Let's take prayer requests. I'd first like to thank you from Leanne, myself, and Drew and Sophie for your generosity. You guys are awesome. We were in tears last night when we got home. I was not expecting anything like that, but thank you for that. And the dinner was wonderful. And I'll be hungry again here in a few minutes, like we talked about. I wasn't hungry for a while after I got home. I lay on the couch and felt like passing out there, watching a ball game or two. But I got to watch one of my players, Zach, play against the number 2 team in the nation, too. So I went home and watched that game. It was just a good evening. So thank you all for that. Also, today, before you leave, if you purchase the poinsettia, you can take that with you if you'd like to decorate for Christmas there around your table. You can take those, and if you want to leave them, you can leave them. But if you'd like to take them, take them, okay? And again, we've got those of you who are here, haven't been here, the poinsettias we're giving in honor of and memory of loved ones who've been in this church and our families. And we just hung those cards up. Dave and I did one evening, Leanne print, wrote them out. So if you want to go by and look at that, you can do that as well. Okay. What am I forgetting? Hope House. Man, what a bunch of stuff we want to take to Hope House. And I can help do that this week. We'll just figure out exactly when we want to do that.
Well,
maybe they come by, don't they?
Dr. Paula, she's going to come and get it tomorrow.
Perfect. Yeah. Perfect. Yeah. That's awesome. Yeah. So thank each one of you who gave for the Hope House. And God will richly bless you and already has. Leah and I, again, we talk about it all the time. We're so blessed to be here. I don't know how to say that. We are blessed to be here. Wouldn't be anywhere else in the world. I'm going to read something to you. Let's take prayer requests, and I'm going to read some scripture to you, and then we're going to turn it over to these talented fellows behind me. The Trinity Valley Travelers.
Yeah.
Trinity Valley Travelers. Eric and I, Eric probably threw me in the swimming pool when I was young. He was friends with my brothers, and so they used to stay on that quite often. And he reminded me this morning, we used to walk through the woods and go to church on Sundays. A little place called Church of God there in Hilton's. But anyway, we've been friends for a long time, and I'm very blessed to have him as a friend, and didn't realize that he was this talented, but looking forward to their music today. And I'll let you introduce everybody and right. Get started. Let's take prayer requests. I have several unspokens that I'd like to mention. Y'all got some of those? Good.
Yeah. Remember those people still in Afghanistan.
Amen. I'd
like to see them come out of there.
I would too. Amen. Thank you. Remember our country. And our leaders, pray for our leaders. Thank you all for praying for our school system. Continue to do that. And everyone here that are employees of our school system, thank you for that. Much needed break now for the teachers and those of the work. Anybody else? Anything you want to mention? Larry and Rita? Keep them remembering them.
I just want to say that Alex came to me and served well.
Awesome.
And of course, he goes back to the doctor tomorrow and they'll determine how much surgery he's going to have. So
great.
That's, I'm sure he's going to be for today. He's done okay.
Yeah. That's good. We've got a cowboy with us today. Good looking cowboy.
Yeah, boy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Looking sharp. To you out of 1 John. We're going to start with this today and end with this today. 1 John chapter 4, beginning in verse 9, says, "In this the love of God was manifested toward us, that God has sent his only begotten Son into the world, that we might live through him. In this is love, not that we love God, but that he loved us and sent his Son to be the propitiation for our sins." In verse 11, "Beloved, if God so loved us, we also ought to love one another." And I'm very grateful to be a part of a loving church. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, thank you for this group of people, God. I just commit them up to you and ask that you would bless their homes and their families. Lord, for these children and for our grandchildren. Lord, as they grow up, Lord, help them to grow up in Christ. Help them to find it, to seek after you and find you. God, I just pray your hedge of protection around their futures right now. And so each and every prayer request we've mentioned, you already know. We present it to you, trusting that you're going to do a mighty work, and we believe that you will. And God, in faith, we are bringing it to you, asking that you would heal and counsel and comfort and provide grace and peace in these situations. Lord, thank you for this time of year. Thank you for Christmas. Lord, thank you for the folks that you brought our way today that are going to provide for us music. Help us to celebrate in our hearts, Lord, the words that are coming through those songs. And certainly, God, it is an offering to you that they come. And so that's our prayer and desire today. Bless us, forgive us, lead God, direct us in Jesus' name. Amen.
Feel like singing, just open your mouth and let it fly.
Here
Grace, from up at Coburn, Virginia, and wife and mom is back here, and glad to have him, and I guess we've been playing together for about a year, year and a half, something like that now, and he don't say a whole lot, but when he does, you kind of have to pay attention, so. But anyway, make him welcome Eric Blankenship. And I'm one of those Hiltonian MacMurrays from up at Ground Timber Tree Branch, and he'll always be Scotty to me. His name may be Scott Remedian, but he's always going to be Scotty to me. I remember when he was about this tall. And I spent a lot of time with his brothers, Dwayne, of course, everybody knows him as Deetsy, and Larry. And we spent a lot of time, I spent a lot of time over there, and I've always thought a lot of that family, and his mom and dad. We played a lot of ball together, and they were just as warm and welcoming families I've ever met. And so I appreciate you giving us the opportunity to come and just share in song, and share the word in song. And we do hope that you get a blessing, and we're looking for a blessing. We're here to play for the Lord. We're not here for ourselves. We just want to have a little bit of fun this morning and bring some songs and smile a little bit. It's Christmas time. We got a lot to be thankful for and a lot to smile about. I mean, I know we got troubles in our lives, and we've had things that's come along the way, but at the end of the day, if you got the Lord, you should be able to smile. So here's one that hope you like our little rendition of it. Oh Lord, my God. Thank you. You talk a while, give a banking description. Since you work in a bank, I've got to get some.
He was banjo picker, guitar player going down the road, going around the highway. They were both saved men, right to the Lord. They had an awful car wreck. Both of them died instantly. St. Peter opened up them pearly gates, and there stood the guitar picker by himself. St. Peter looked around behind him, said, "What happened to your banjo player?" Guitar player said, "I don't know, he had to stop and get something."
Or tune.
Normally he'd say tune, but we appreciate y'all having us. Y'all bear with us. We have to tune these things because you've got steel strings pulling on wood. And with the heat and the temperature and all that. So, and we need to sound just as good as we can.
What we gonna do now?
Let's speed it up. Come on, have
it. All right, we can do more. All right. Thank you.
Black as the storm, the sky, the brown in bottom.
want me to, being where you're at, the locality, the mountains, we're gonna sing you one a cappella. And I'm sure you all folks have heard this style of music performed. And I imagine not too far from here, it's probably being sung this way right now. My Bible tells me,
my Lord has gone.
Master.
27, but don't hold me to that. As I told Eric this morning, I got the senior citizen coffee that stayed, so I can't remember as well as I used to. But anyway, I hope you like this one. It's always been one of my favorites, and we'll try to do all four verses here if we can. One called, Where the Soul Never Dies.
And so for all the promises that we have and the
be able to see loved ones and the blessings and the grace and mercy in our life. And all come back through a manger. And, you know, we talk about a manger, but I heard someone, a pastor, say a few days ago, my grandsons were in a Christmas program at church. And you know that manger was actually a king-size baby. You ever thought about that? That manger was actually a king-size baby. And I thought that was really appropriate. So I hope you like this before Scotty comes up and we'll do you one here that like I said, you are all more than welcome to sing along with us.
Bye. morning. When we were building our house, I did a lot of it myself, and some of it I had, had to sit down and, you know, plan out, you know, draw it out like a blueprint, except if I didn't buy blueprints, we'd draw our own out, you know. Same thing when I was coaching, you know, when we start a season, we always had a plan, and we met for days and days, and we went to clinics and got along as a staff, and we come up with a plan. And, you know, when I think about Christmas, Christmas is the time of year where God's perfect plan was carried out in His Son Jesus, and we talked about a baby in a manger, a king-sized bed. I just want to share with you today God's perfect plan and how love falls into that, because really, the love of God was brought forth in the manger, wasn't it? In a baby who grew and lived as we live, except without sin. And I'm going to read about that today, God's perfect plan. First, the promise in Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6, the promise. Some 700 years before the birth of Christ, Isaiah prophesied about the promise. Let me read that to you. It's 9:6, and Isaiah says, "For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulder. And his name will be called Wonderful." Isn't Jesus Christ wonderful? Counselor. Is there a better counselor? No, there's not. Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. We see the promise of God's perfect plan. And then in Luke chapter 2, if you want to turn there with me, Luke chapter 2, starting in verse 1, we see the path that God chose to take in providing that promise to mankind. It says, "And it came to pass in those days that a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. This census first took place while Quirinius was governing Syria. So all went to be registered, everyone to his own city." I think it's neat how God orchestrates things so that we experience His touch and His grace and salvation. He causes things to happen. Have you ever been inconvenienced with a census? And you had to pick up and go, you know what I mean? God orchestrates things. It says in verse 4, "Joseph also went up from Galilee out of the city of Nazareth into Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be registered with Mary, his betrothed wife, who was with child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were completed for her to be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a king-sized bed in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn." Verse 8, "Now there were in the same country shepherds living out in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. And behold, an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them. And they were greatly afraid." A lot of times, we talked a few weeks ago, if you remember, that sometimes when the Spirit of the Lord comes upon us, or we get a word from God, it sometimes brings fear, because it almost seems impossible. But the angel said here, "Then the angel said to them, Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which will be to all people. For there is born to you this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be the sign to you. You will find a babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger." In verse 13, "And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts, praising God, saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace and goodwill toward men." You know, God sent His Son to be born in Bethlehem, a virgin, to live as we live, except without sin. And we know that He gave His life for us so that we could be saved, so that we could experience eternal life. The path is through Jesus. No matter what any talk show might say or what any philosopher might say, the only way to the throne, to God, to the Father, is through Jesus. John 14:6 says, Jesus says, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. And no one comes to me or comes to the Father except through me." And so we find the promise. We find the path to God's perfect plan. But I also want to read some scripture to you today and reassure you that there's purpose in this life. No matter how tough life can get sometimes, we have purpose. And our purpose is to love other people. There's two commandments, love God and love others. And so as we walk this earth and as we walk together, I experienced the love last night, and I know you did too, just a family. Dave and I talked about it this morning. You're just a close-knit family, the church of God. And so we love one another. with that same love that God poured out on us through Jesus Christ, we are to love one another. And so I'm going to end by reading the same scripture that I started with today. In 1 John chapter 4, verses 9 through 11. It says, "In this love of God was manifested toward us, that God has sent His only begotten Son into the world that we might live through Him. In this is love. Not that we love God, but He loved us. And He came seeking after us, like you said earlier. He loved us and sent His Son to be the propitiation for our sins." In verse 11, "Beloved, if God so loved us, we ought also to love one another." Call to love, that's our purpose. And if you find yourself loving and serving, you'll find that you have less time to complain and less time to see the bad. And so, call to love, I encourage you to love. So as they play these next few songs, if you're here today and you do not know Jesus as your Lord and Savior, I would be more than happy. I'll be right up here to speak to you about that. We can pray about that. And the sinner's prayer, and you can be saved today. And so if that is why you're here today, then I welcome you to the front. If you have some things that you're dealing with, I would recommend and suggest that you give those to God as they sing these last few songs. And let us go to the Lord in prayer at this time, and they'll finish up with us. Aren't they awesome? Let's give them a nice hand. If the Lord's dealing with you in any way, I'm up here at the front. You can come up. Heavenly Father, thank you for this time. Thank you for your perfect plan. We know that you're a God of love and that you love us through your Son by giving your Son. Lord, we can come to you, but we need to come in the name of Jesus. And I just thank you for Jesus. I thank you for Christmas. I thank you for these men who have come to serve today. I pray you bless them. I pray you bless their families. Lord, if you're dealing with anyone this morning, God, give them the courage to come forward. Give them the courage to give to you whatever it is that's on their heart. We love you and thank you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Children, go where I send thee.
Well, when I was growing up in Timber Tree Branch, and
waiting to see if we were gonna go to school about this time of year, a couple of weeks before, you know. Weather seemed to be a little bit more snowy. Like I said that way, a little bit more snowy back in the day, but we always had Jimmy Smith, the Ridge Runner. Whoever remembers Jimmy Smith and the Ridge Runner on WGAT, we'd be listening to that. And wait and see if we got our name called. Well, we're on the snow schedule, we're off, and I hope we'd be off so we could go play the snow. But anyway, and I always heard this song just about, I don't know if he played it more than one time when his radio program in the morning. I don't know if he played it more than one time, but I just about every time that I can remember of waiting on to find out, I'd hear this song. And you all sang along with us. It's a song that Tex Logan wrote and Billman wrote, recorded it. And I know God created everything. He created bluegrass gospel and bluegrass music. And this is a bluegrass Christmas song, and you all sing along with us. And if I don't see you on this side of eternity, we'll see you on the other side. How's that? And everybody have a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. And thank you, God, for having us. We've been blessed to be here, and we just thank you very much. I'm the old man of the group, so they have to kind of keep me in line. Snowflakes falling, my mama's calling, doll mine coming, Christmas time's done. Hear that bell ringing, ringing, joy, joy, dancing. When it's snowed, I'll be going back to my country home.
Thank you for helping me ask you.